With Agenda 17, you'll supercharge your note-taking, as you can now open your notes and projects in separate windows on both your Mac and your iPad. And we think it will change the way you'll work with Agenda, and that it will help you organize your days even better. So let's see it in action. So let's start right away with a good example. As you might remember from a previous video, I was taking lessons on scuba diving. So here I am watching a YouTube video, and I'd like to take some notes. Now before, I would always have to struggle to fit the agenda window next to my video, so I could easily take notes. Now in Agenda 17, it has become a lot easier. So if I click this button in the bottom right corner of the note, it jumps out in a separate window. Now this window is a lot easier to put next to my video. There, that makes note-taking a lot easier. Agenda is a so-called shoebox app. It's where all your notes live in a single place. The app takes care of where they're stored on disk, you don't have to worry. You just work with a single window where on the left you have your overviews and your projects. In the middle you can work on your notes. And on the right you see your calendar and your events and reminders. So that in one single window you have a nice and clean overview of everything. But like I've just shown you, in some cases it can actually be really useful to open a note or a project in a separate window. For instance, on a video call, I'd like to see my notes and the participants at the same time and not have this big agenda window block my view. Or when I'm comparing two notes, I would like to see them side by side. So let's go over a few more examples, and I can also show you some tips on how to make it even more powerful. The first thing I wanted to show is that not only can you open a single note in a separate window, you can also open a project or an overview in a separate window. For instance, if I select this Developing Yak app project and click the three dots, I can open it in a separate window. I can add notes or search. I can even switch to a different project if I click the category name. For instance, I can go to the On the Agenda overview and keep that in a separate window, which can be really useful throughout the day. And while I can use the button in a note or these three dots next to the project to open a separate window, often the easiest way is to simply hit Cmd-O to open the selected item in a separate window. I can even select multiple projects, hit Cmd-O, and now I have all the notes for those two projects in a single window. This works with both multiple projects as well as multiple overviews. Now as you can see, later today I have this presentation that I'm going to give. And here are my talking points. So of course I can open this in a separate window, so that if I remember additional things I need to say, I can quickly add them while I work on other things. Now ideally I'd like to have this window open while I'm working on my presentation, but as you can see, if I switch to Keynote, the agenda window goes to the background and I can no longer see my notes. If I go back to Agenda and click on the three dots in the top right corner of this window, I can choose to have it stay on top of everything. Which means that if I now go to Keynote, my window is still there and I can still access my talking points and use them to prepare for my presentation. And if I'm done, I can switch back to have it behave like a normal window. Now if I go to Keynote, it no longer stays on top. So one of the reasons why you would want to open a note or a project in a separate window is that the main window would then stay at where you currently are, and you wouldn't have to go back to find that note where you came from. So let me show you some places where this can be really useful. So in Agenda 17, pretty much everywhere where you see a note or a project or a link to a note or a project, you can open it in a separate window if you hold the Alt Option key. For instance, I can click on this recently edited note and it will open in a window. Or for instance, in this table of contents, instead of jumping to the team meeting in this main window, if I hold the Alt Option key and click it, it will open in a separate window. The same is true for linked notes in the calendar or notes or projects that you link to in the text of your note. For instance, if I hold the Alt Option key and click on this link in the text, it will open a note in a separate window as well, keeping the main window at where it is. Now, if I do want to show this note in the main window, you'll notice that the button here in the bottom right corner looks a bit different. And when I click it, it will open that note in the main window of Agenda. Now, of course, opening too many windows at the same time is not a good idea either. But in case you ever get lost, here's a tip. If you click on the dock icon of Agenda, it will always bring you back to the main window. I bet you already started thinking about how you are going to use this when you're working in Agenda, especially with multiple notes. But there is a case where this can be really great if you want to focus on just a single note. Let me show you what I mean. So if you look carefully, if I press the Alt Option key, the icon in the bottom right corner changes to show a full screen icon. If I click it, it will open this note straight away in full screen mode, without any distraction of a busy calendar or my sidebar. I can just focus on this single note. Now, if you use a lot of formatting in your notes, you might be familiar with the formatting palette that you can show if you click the little round button in the gutter. I can use it to select, for instance, a heading style or change a paragraph into a checklist, or apply formatting like bold or underline to text. If I click somewhere else, it will go away. But new in Agenda 17 is that you can actually take this paragraph palette and drag it off. And it will now become a little window that will stay on screen until you actively close it. So the last thing I wanted to show is how you can combine this full screen mode with a feature in macOS that perhaps not many people know. If I click and hold the green window button, I get the option to put this window into full screen mode, but only on the left half of the screen. In the other half, I can, for instance, pick my video call. And in that way, I can keep my notes and look at the participants at the same time. I can even change how much space I want to give to each of the two. Wow, that's a great note-taking setup. Well, actually, talking about great note-taking setups, so far, everything I've shown you with Agenda 17 was on the Mac. But we made those same changes on Agenda for iPad OS as well. And now you can open multiple notes or projects or even multiple copies of Agenda at the same time on your iPad, which is a game changer. So let me show you that. The first thing you'll notice in Agenda 17 on iPad that the notes have the same button as on the Mac. If I tap it, I can now open a note in a separate window that floats above my main window. I can edit this note and not be distracted by anything else. And when I'm done, I can simply tap in the background and it's dismissed. Note how at the bottom of the window, you can see thumbnails of the notes and projects that I have opened. I can even create a new window. I can open the sidebar, pick a different note, and continue working like this. And at any point, if I want to return to the ones I was before, I tap the three dots at the top of the screen to move to any of my other notes. If I want to close a window, I simply tap the three dots and close it. On iPad, there are several ways how you can use a window. We've already seen how I can open a note floating above the main window. But if I tap the three dots, I can also make it full screen. I can make it take half the screen together with another app. Or I can put it in so-called slide over, which makes my note float above the window of another app. Simply pick the combination that works best for you. Like on the Mac, you can also pick a project or an overview in a separate window. For instance, if I go to On the Agenda, I tap the three dots next to it and I can open it in a separate window. Or even easier, I simply start dragging the project to the edge of the screen and I can open it in a separate window. And this works for pretty much everything. If I want to open this note in slide over, I just drag it towards the edge of the screen and release it. And if I want to change from slide over into split view, I just start dragging the three dots to the edge of the screen and now it's in split view. The same I can do, for instance, with the related note. I can just pick it up and drag it to the edge of the screen. There you go. And of course, where this really works well is in a new Stage Manager feature of iOS 16. You can make new windows, work together with other apps, or open multiple Agenda windows next to each other. Finally, just like on the Mac, you can now also open the Tag Manager in a separate window. And keep it open if you like, next to your Agenda window. So this really changes the way Agenda works on iPad, and it makes it much more powerful, much more like working on a Mac. So the last thing I wanted to talk about is the number of changes we made to the so-called premium features of Agenda. Now, the ability to open a note or a project in a separate window is a so-called premium feature of Agenda. So what does that mean? Well, Agenda is free to download and free to use for as long as you want, and that's true for pretty much all its features. But we do feel that there is a set of features that really supercharges your note-taking. Now, normally in other apps, if you would go premium, you would basically be forced to pay a monthly or a yearly fee in order to keep those features. Because if you would stop paying, they would take them from you and you basically lose everything. So we're not a big fan of this model. We believe that if you buy something, you should own it. And if you decide to stop paying us, because for whatever reason, that you should continue to own the things you've already bought. Now, this is the model we've always had and we feel is fair towards both us as developers and you as a user. But it is different from what most apps do, which meant that it's not always easy to explain exactly how it works. So in Agenda 17, we made it a bit simpler. If you buy the premium features of Agenda, you will start a yearly subscription. But mind you, it still works exactly as before, in that you will get all the premium features that are there today, plus any new ones we'll release during your subscription. And importantly, if you decide to cancel your subscription, you will always keep what you have at that moment. You will just not receive any new ones anymore. We believe that that's just easier to understand, but essentially it's the same thing. Now, even better, you can now also try the features before you decide to buy them. Now, for those who really don't like subscriptions, we're also introducing a so-called lifetime option, which means that you can buy with a single purchase, not only the premium features that are there today, but also any premium feature we'll release in the future while you're using Agenda with just a single purchase. And of course, that's more expensive than a yearly subscription in the short run, but ultimately would reward you if you keep on using Agenda and are a loyal user of our app, which of course we would love to see happen. And know that if you buy those premium features, not only would you give a huge boost to your note-taking capabilities in Agenda, but you would also be supporting us, Drew and me, as a small independent app maker, and your support would be immensely appreciated as it allows us to do what we love doing, which is, as a small team, make a great software product. We're a small team, but at the same time, we're not sitting still. And like last time, we decided to split our efforts. So while I've been working mainly on the multiple windows feature of Agenda 17, Drew has already started working on Agenda 18. And that will bring the ability to add a password to Agenda or to your notes, which means that if, like me, you share your iPad with your kids, you're sure that at least they don't get access to your notes. And similarly, if say you're screen sharing with a colleague, you're also sure that they can't see your notes on the screen. So that will come in Agenda 18. If you want to know when that comes out, I will make another video. So be sure to subscribe to the channel so that you'll be the first to know. And in the meantime, try out Agenda 17 by downloading it from the App Store and let us know what you think, either here in the comments or on the Agenda community. And yes, also the Agenda community can now be opened in a separate window on your iPad. So that aside, I'm looking forward to see you again soon when Agenda 18 comes out. And in the meantime, enjoy this new update. We're looking forward to hear what you think. Ciao.